Stay home, save lives.
Dear students, today we start a new topic, ray optics. In ray optics, there are many chapters which deals with mirrors, lenses, and then optical instruments. The topic which I am going to take up for you all now is optical instruments, where we have to study about microscopes and telescopes. Now, why do we need optical instruments? When a normal human eye is not in a position to see very minute objects and very far off objects like planets and all, we require optical instruments. Now, optical instruments can be of various types, but mainly in every optical instrument, we use the principle of reflection of light or refraction of light. Now, first optical instrument is a simple microscope. Now, simple microscope is a device which has been seen by each and every one of us in some or the other form. A simple microscope is nothing but a magnifying glass. What is the purpose of a magnifying glass? When very minute object is there, we focus through the lens and we are able to see the minute objects quite broad over there, and then we are able to see them. Now the point is, a simple microscope is nothing but a magnifying glass. Secondly, a magnifying glass, what do we see? It just consists of a single converging lens, that is a single convex lens. Now, what is the principle of this simple microscope? Its principle is basically that when the object is placed very close to the eye, then the image form is highly magnified, virtual and erect. Now, this is just a very wide, a general explanation of simple microscope. We need to go in for the ray diagram and the mathematical expressions for simple microscope. Now, the main point is, before we actually start with simple microscope, we need to know few things before that. Now, suppose this is an object. Now, I am able to see this object very clearly only when it lies at least distance of distinct vision. Students, as you are already aware, what is least distance of distinct vision? When the distance at which the human eye is able to see the object very clearly, that distance is called least distance of distinct vision, and its value is 25 centimeter. Now, if I just imagine that this is my object and this is my eye, this is the least distance of distinct vision. The angle it makes is alpha. Now, if I bring it closer, the angle alpha will be broad. If I take it far away, the angle alpha will keep on decreasing. But I cannot bring this closer to my eye. Reason, I will not be able to see it very clearly. If I want to see it more clearly, I need to use an optical instrument. For example, a simple microscope. Now, what is a simple microscope? A simple microscope is a magnifying glass. Now, we have to do simple microscope in two positions. When the object lies at focus and when the object lies between focus and optical center. Now, when I see here the human eye with this object distance, the angle which it makes, we call it as the angle subtended by the object to the human eye, that is called alpha. The magnification is actually defined as angle subtended by the image to the angle subtended by the object. Now, here in this position, when the object is kept at focus, we have already studied that when the object is placed at focus, the image is formed at infinity. So, the infinity, somewhere when the image will be formed, and if I assume its angle, it will be the angle over here. Like the object will be formed somewhere here, this angle for this triangle and for that big triangle will remain the same. So, what is tan beta for it? It will be perpendicular upon base. Now, for this figure, what is tan alpha? H upon D, which is equal to alpha upon H by D, because this angle is not going to be very big, it is going to be very small. So, I can write tan alpha as simply alpha. From this figure, what do we observe? That tan beta is equal to H by F. That is beta equal to H by F. From the definition of magnification, when I substitute the parameters, I get N equal to beta by alpha, which is equal to H upon F into D by H. The value of magnification comes out to be D by F. More will be the focal length, less will be the magnification, less will be the focal length, more will be the magnification. Now we can easily judge from these two formulas that magnification has taken place, because the focal length distance is less than this. When the focal length distance F is going to be less than B, beta is going to be more than alpha. That means magnification has taken place. Now we come to the second position where the object is kept between focus and optical center of the convex lens. The object is at between F and pole, optical center. The image is formed at least distance of distinct vision. Say the height of the image is h dash. Now here again we have to use the formula of magnification, which says visual angle subtended by the image to the visual angle subtended by the object. Now here if I take this triangle, bigger one or the smaller one, in both the cases they are similar triangles, so beta can be taken for height h also and beta can be taken for height h dash also. So what do I get? Tan beta is equal to h by u, implies beta equal to h by u. Again, this angle beta is going to be very, very small. And from the previous figure, if you remember, tan alpha was equal to h by d, alpha equal to h by d. Substituting in the similar manner as the previous case, we get magnification as d by u. Now, u is what? U is an object distance which is not the focal length, but it is lesser than the focal length. That means we need to calculate the distance in terms of f. Because once you buy a magnifying glass, you only know its focal length. So now we have the lens formula, which says that 1 by V minus 1 by U equal to 1 by F. I know if I multiply this V on both the sides, that is right hand side as well as the left hand side, I get 1 minus V by U equal to V by F. V is in this direction, U is also in this direction, and the light is moving in the opposite direction. So they both are negative. When I substitute, I get d by u equal to 1 plus d by fe. Comparing this equation and this equation, I get m equal to 1 plus d by f. That means in both the cases, focal length is always in the denominator, which means if I want a simple microscope to magnify maximum, its focal length should be very, very less. That means a convex lens of short focal length is a good magnifying glass.